Thank you so much for coming today. I'm Fran Levine, the director of the History Museum, and it's our great pleasure to welcome you to the holiday season concert. You might ask why we're not having this concert in the auditorium, and that's because Schola Cantorum and the monks from Christ in the Desert love this space. We offered them St. Francis Cathedral. They said, no, we like this space. And I think we didn't realize when we built this building how much this glass, this two-story space, would do for the sound. And so it's just lovely, and we know that it's a little bit uncomfortable for the audience, but I think once they, you know, when I came in, I parked my car and I walked in the door, and they were clearing their throats, and it sounded fabulous. And then they sang hello to me in perfect harmony. It doesn't get any better than that. If you do need a place to sit, there are a couple places here where you can sit on the stairs down here or on their stairs going upstairs. There are people in the two-story space. And if somebody is, if you look around and you see somebody who looks like they need to sit down and you're okay relinquishing your seat, they'll sing to you for doing that. So this concert brings to a close our last month of being in the presence of the St. John's Bible and the Contemplative Landscape Exhibit. And I'd like you to please thank Tom Leach, who is the curator of the St. John's Bible Exhibit. Our former curator of photography, who is a curator of contemplative landscape and office. These have been wonderful shows for us. They close on December 31st, so I hope you'll come at least once a week between now and then, and more if you need to, because I think when that meditation space closes upstairs, the town will sorely miss it. And so, please join us often. Tom and Marianne did a great job combining those two exhibits together. In fact, we were received an honorable mention from the American Association for State and Local History this year for the innovation. St. John's Bible has been shown in many places, but no place has ever combined it with the faith experiences of their community and their state. So I think Tom and Marianne did just a brilliant job in that combination. Cards. And if you attended a number of these events and you'd like to tell us how much you enjoyed them and what things you'd like us to do more of and what we ought to do less of, please let us know. This month also brings to an end our centennial exhibition and our centennial letter writing project. And someone asked me in the beginning, how will you know if this project succeeds? And I said, well, we'll get 100 letters. Well, at the end of the first week, when we told people and we had received 100 letters, we upped our goal. We wanted a letter from every county in New Mexico. We haven't gotten it quite from every county, but many people have written to us about their lives in New Mexico, what brought them here, what it is about New Mexico that's special. And we're writing these letters to the future to tell people about our lives now. So it's not too late. We'd love to have your letter. We'd love to have your comments about the St. John's Bible and Contemplative Landscape Exhibits. And we're thrilled that you joined us again today. And I'm going to ask the wonderful Billy Turney, who's the choral director of Schola Cantorum, to come forward and tell us about this most magical, magical of choirs. Thank you for being here.
Good afternoon, and oh, thank you. I feel special. So I am the director of the Schola Cantorum, a group that I actually founded back in 1990. And Gregorian chant is really kind of my specialty. I was the organist at the cathedral for a long time, And I used to have red hair back then, but those were good years. But at any rate, things are still going, and we have this great group, and we've varied in size through the years of maybe a half a dozen up to almost two dozen right now. And we have a really fun group right now. We have quite a variety in ages in the group, of people that are 70. Right down to people that are teenagers, and I will tell you that all of them keep me on my toes. And so it's really been a great trip for all these years, and I think right now we're almost kind of at our best in the thoughts that bringing on lots of new music. I've really challenged this group. It's an amateur choir from the standpoint that they don't get at least 50% of their income from music. You know, that's the definition of a professional musician. But I'll tell you, I don't think you'll be disappointed in saying, you know, these aren't indeed professionals in the sacred music arena. Just yesterday we sang at the Chemo Theater, and we sang with some really top drawer musicians. They were playing ancient instruments, and there's only a few people on the planet that do this kind of music, and they really were very complimentary to the group, and I'd like to take all the credit, but it's really everybody in the group that makes it happen. And so I think they're great. I hope that you'll think they're great as well. You can be the judge of that. But they've really made a long journey in just a few months, getting ready for this trip that we're taking to Italy in January, where we're going to sing in Venice and Florence and Rome and sing in St. Peter's Basilica. So we're very excited. Part of this journey for me has been getting to interact with the monks at the Monastery of Christ in the Desert and getting to know Father Abbot Philip and all of the community. And I go up there, I try to get up there once a month or so and give them lessons in Gregorian chant and choral technique and piano lessons. And, you know, I always go up there to help them, but I can assure you I'm the one who comes back with all the gifts every single time. And it's just a beautiful day. I drive up in the morning like any good person, fighting the traffic and getting up there. It's like, oh my gosh, and I get up there. I go into the community, and I mean, the greeting is peace be with you, and that's just, it's peaceful, and I teach some music, and then I go to their liturgy of the hours where you hear the real prayers being chanted back and forth from side to side of the chapel, and then I dine with them in silence, and you know, I always go back, and the sky is blue, and there's road rage, and they're all waving at me, and I'm waving back. So I'm just absolutely thrilled to see the community here again today. So welcome all of you, and you're going to get to hear a variety today. The Schola, we're going to sing some chant with the monks. We're going to sing a little bit of Renaissance music, and then we have some Christmas carols that we're going to share with you. I think there's some beautiful a cappella settings. So welcome, and sit back and relax. Looks like you are, and we're going to share some music with you this afternoon. Thank you.
Thank you. taller than I am. So, I just wanted to give you one clue. This is eight of us monks. These eight are from seven countries. Try to guess which two are from the same country. We're going to sing the Alma Redemptoris Mater in the solemn tone. We begin this on the first Sunday of Advent. We sing it all the way through until February 2nd at the end of our day.
Are going to share with you a piece that comes from 12th century France, in Paris in particular. And it was a new kind of writing called organum. And it's very different. And there's just a few words in this particular piece. And it's actually part of the Christmas Day Mass. And the words in Latin are Viderunt Omnes. And it translates into Psalm 98, all the ends of the earth have seen the power of God. And that's a very loose translation. So we're going to share that with you, and the piece is about 20 minutes long. So we're just going to do the first eight or so pages, which means it's going to be about 3 or 4 minutes in length. But it'll give you the idea of how Notre Dame de Paris sounded in its very early days, and that kind of music that is so different. So again, it's called Organum. The composer of this, his name was Perrotin. There's not much known about him. And if you've ever heard of Anonymous, he's the person who actually wrote the most about it. You've heard of the Anonymous Four group? It's named after that particular thing. So at any rate, get ready to step back in time and hear some music that may be very unfamiliar to your ear. But at any rate, you'll get a chance to glimpse into the past, 1,000 years.
Thank you.
Edmund said, I'm not speaking loudly enough, so I have to make sure you can hear me. So, I think you know that we are not a choir, we're a monastery. So when we sing, it's simply the prayer that we normally sing. And I told the brothers, don't be frightened. We'll make all our mistakes that we make at home. And you'll accept us as we are, because we come here simply to share our prayer with you. I'm always touched when we can still sing publicly about faith in Jesus and in the Lord. So, look at one. The first one we sang was a song to Mary. That's how we end every day, with a song to the Mother of Jesus. This one is not part of our liturgy. It's about Jesus born in Bethlehem, and you probably all heard it before, but it's very typical of the kind of thing that we might sing at recreation. I can't imagine you singing at recreation, but we might. Okay, so listen.
Tu eatus in Bethlehem, alleluia, unde caudet Jerusalem, alleluia, alleluia. In cordes jubilo Christum natum adoremus, un novo cantico. Assumsit carnem filius, alleluia, Dei patris officibus, alleluia, alleluia. In cordes jubilo Christum natum adoremus, un novo cantico. Per Gabriele nuncium, alleluia, Virgo concepit filium, alleluia, alleluia. In cordes jubilo Christum natum adoremus, cum novo cantico. Et angelus pastoribus, alleluia, revelat potsit Dominus, alleluia, alleluia. In cordes jubilo Christum natum adoremus, cum novo cantico. Reges de Sabathenium, alleluia, aurum tus myrtam offertum, alleluia, alleluia. In cordes jubilo Christum natum adoremus, un novo cantico. Ne mare natus virgine, alleluia, qui lumen est illumine, alleluia, alleluia. In cordis jubilo Christum natum adoremus, un novo cantico. Sine serpentis punere, alleluia, de nostro venit sanguine, alleluia, alleluia. In cordis jubilo Christum natum adoremus, cum novo cantico. In hoc natali gaudio, alleluia, benedicamus Domino, alleluia, alleluia. In cordes jubilo Christum natum adoremus, un novo cantico. Laudetur Sancta Trinitas, alleluia, Deo dicamus gratias, alleluia, alleluia. In cordis jubilo natum adoremus cum novo cantico.
That's why I enjoy my day at the monastery. Yeah, absolutely beautiful. Thank you so much for sharing that. We're going to share a piece that translates into English as Rejoice, the Jesus is born of the Virgin Mary. And so this is a piece that was kind of buried away in Europe for a long time. And it was first written down around the 15th or 16th century when it appeared in a choir book. And it was pretty popular for a century or so, and then it kind of disappeared. And in the last century, there was some scholarly work happening, and someone came across this and said, oh, this is a pretty neat song, let's try it. And now it's kind of gone around the world, and it's become pretty popular again. And it's known in its name in Latin as Gaudete.
Gaudete, gaudete, Christus est natus, ex Maria Virgine, gaudete, 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 Christus est natus, ex Maria Virgine, gaudete.
Voices like that. Aren't they beautiful? In our own prayer, we sing quite a bit in Latin, but during the day, everything is in English. We're going to sing you now an English hymn. When we sing in English, there are translations from the Latin, but with the traditional melodies. And in Gregorian chant, often, there are always two sides, so you either have two sides of the choir, or you have a cantor versus a group of the monks, or you have a group of cantors versus the rest of the choir. This one we're going to do with Brother Kedman, who's going to sing. We're going to sing all together one verse, he'll sing the alternate verses. This is very traditional to keep you focused on the words. And the next one I'll tell you where we're from.
Oh,
Christ, Redeemer of us all. You who are the Father's only Son, the only Son before all time, yet born to us in wondrous way. O Father's light and splendor Christ, O everlasting hope of all, direct your heart to hear the prayers your servants make throughout the world. O you who saved us from our sins, now call to mind the heaven your birth. You then did take our bodies form, born of the Virgin undefiled. The present day does testify, as it comes round in every year, that you, the world's salvation, Lord, alone came from the Father's throne. The heavens and the earth and sea, and all the things that are, rejoice in song and praise our God, the author of your coming, Lord. We also who have been redeemed by your holy blood accord, now sing a new song in your praise on this the day that I saw your birth. All glory be to you, O Lord, who from the Virgin have been born with Father and with Spirit.
Evan and I came up with a plan. It does not have anything to do with monk's ale, yet. Over here to your right is a beautiful manuscript book, and it's dated 1792. And it comes from Salamanca, Spain, and it's a Christmas Gregorian chant book. And so inside of that is what's called the introit, which sounds like the word introduction, for Christmas Day Mass. And so in the Trinitine Mass, which was in effect until the 1960s, the way that Mass started was you had a blessing before the Mass started, the asparagus it was called, and then it went directly into this introit, and then it would be immediately followed by the Kyrie, and then immediately followed by the Gloria. So there could be easily 15 or 20 minutes straight of Gregorian chant. We're just going to give you a piece of that, but we're going to involve the monks and all of the Schola, and we're going to sing out of this book, and it's really good. It has big letters. Is that true, Father Rabbit? They have cheat sheets. Of course they have cheat sheets. The monks came with cheat sheets for the Gregorian chant book. Anywho, we're going to gather around this big book, and we're going to have a game plan in just one more second. Yes, another game plan, and we're going to share with you some singing out of this big book.
Well,
principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum.
Probably closer how Gregorian chant sounded. What we have is a very smooth tone that comes from the rediscovery of Gregorian chant in the 1900s, 1800s, 19th century, but has become common. Most people don't know that there's still a living tradition of Gregorian chant. They're still interpreting it. I learned it one way when I was young, and now they say, no, you have to sing this note that way, because they go back and look at the manuscripts. This manuscript is different from the one we sing at home. Comes from a different tradition. Most people aren't going to know any of that, and I'm not sure it's very useful knowledge, but it helps you understand. We're going to sing now what's called a gradual. Today in the Catholic liturgy, there's a responsorial psalm after the first reading. There used to be a gradual. It's the same thing, but it's in Latin, and you'll hear this. It's a place where in the tradition, a soloist could have a heyday, you know, because he can sing what he wants and nobody knows the difference as long as he ends up on the right note so they can pick it up again.
Ascendet in montem Domum.
You applaud because I forgot to name where we're from. Okay. Brother Vianney is from Kenya. I'm going to skip Brother Benwick for a minute. Brother Philip is from Kerala, India. Brother Kedman is from the Philippines. John Baptist is from Inner Mongolia in China. Brother Aylred is from Zambia. Brother Luke Maria is from Mexico. And now I say Brother Benedict's from Colorado. He and I are the two from the same country.
I'm going to ask the Schola to sing something that's always in season year-round. It's called Pia Jesu. And the words in English are, "Merciful Jesus, grant them eternal rest." And a couple of them, including myself, of members of the choir, we lost our mother just in the last few weeks. And as we think about our mothers and fathers and relatives and friends who have gone before us, we can all take a moment and just kind of remember them through these beautiful words and really this beautiful song that was set by Michael McGlynn. But the beautiful words again, Pia Jesu, thinking, you know, about those that are gone before us, especially during this Christmas season, as always in the holidays and Christmas season, we think about those that have left us, and the holidays can be hard.
Thank you.
trying to make it too easy for me. We're going to sing, the next one is the offertory for the fourth Sunday of Advent. All the music we've sung is Advent and Christmas music, and it all speaks in Latin or in English about the coming of Jesus. This one is a song to our Blessed Mother again, to Mary, and it's one that probably many people have heard, but we sing it every Saturday at home during ordinary time, but it's properly the offertory for the fourth Sunday of Advent. It's just the Hail Mary in Latin.
No.
at him. Because he's up to some shenanigans.
I said, we don't have any more music. I prepared for a 1-hour concert, and I knew they were going to be half. So I said, but he sent this music to us.
Father Abbott, it's a 2-hour program.
Oh,
you didn't get the memo today?
Now he tells me. We have to be home by Vespers tonight.
Do you want dispensation today?
Yes, but he sent us this music, which is Advent music, Vorate Cieli De Super, that Nubes Buon. May the heavens open up and may the earth rain down the Savior. This is one of the great cries of Advent. It's all about desire for God. And for us to desire for Jesus, but I think we can all appreciate the desire for something transcendent, something beyond us. And this is a great cry coming from the Psalms. So we're going to do it, and he and I are going to alternate verses.
Okay.
Et nubes fluant justum, ne hieros caris Domine, ne ultra me mineris iniquitatis, et recivitas sancti facta est deserta, si hon deserta facta. Jerusalem desolata es, domus sanctificationis tuae, et gloriae tuae, ubi lauda verunt te, patres nostri. Orate, Cieli te super, et nubes fluat justum. Eca habimus, et facti sumus, tamquam immovundus nos, et decidimus, quasi folium universi, et iniquitates nostre quasi ventrus absulerunt nos, abscondidisti faciem ad nobis, et alicisti nos in manu iniquitatis nostre. Prorate, Cieli te super, et nubes fluant justum. Vite Domine afflictionem populi tui, et mihite quem misurus est. Et emite annum dominatorem terrae, de petra deserti ad montem filiae siro, et auferat ipse jugum captivitatis nos. Prorate, Cieli te super, et nubes fluant justum.
This is almost where we have the battle of the chains. So the as we close out our program here, it really is an hour today, Father Abbott. He knew that. The Schola and the monks were going to join together to sing Salve Regina. See, the Schola's eyes aren't real big. So, and what this is, this is a song to Mary, a hymn to Mary, that is sung during ordinary time. And so we're going to all join together that. Thank you very much this afternoon. And of course, please always do support the monks. I don't know if they brought CDs today. Did you bring CDs?
No.
Oh, they didn't. But hey, you know that they're they have to be very self-sufficient, and so you've heard of monk's ale and things like that, and we laugh about that, and that sounds like a good thing. But it's a way that they make a living, and they live very simply, and they really appreciate anything they can get. So you can buy their beer. That's one way for sure. But you can also
drink beer and support the monks.
And that's why I'm their front man today. Goodness gracious. I can get confession after this for thinking stuff? Or can I get confession right after this for thinking stuff? Or can I get the absolution? Whew, clean slate. Here we go. So we're going to still sing the Salve Regina. So anyway, please do support the monks. And for us, if you would like to purchase a CD, we'd be happy to sign that for you, take it home for Christmas. We even have a bag. Perhaps you can hand me a bag there, Peter. Peter is being our point man today. Look at these beautiful bags. Wouldn't you like to have one? Say yes. Yes. Okay, look, you can put all your Christmas presents in this and even give it to somebody in that bag. How about that? And look at how this it's like Santa Claus is right here. So, thank you, Peter. Oh my gosh. And so with that, Gail, come on up and take some pictures of us. She's our official photographer, because we want to remember these very special ones. And so thank you again as we sing Salve Regina.
Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, vita dulcedo, et sens nostra salve.
I just want to publicly thank Billy and the Schola Cantorum. They always invite us to come along, and we're very grateful for Billy's work with our community to help us sing and to be on key. And again, I'll remind you, support them and drink beer for us. God bless you.
They were going to plug their beer. We would have provided. You know, our programming is all made possible by a grant that we have from the New Mexico Humanities Council that has supported our entire year of programming for St. John's and contemplative landscape, matched by contributions from the Museum of New Mexico Foundation, so your foundation memberships, those who support the Exhibition Development Fund, the Leadership Fund, all of those funds help us put on these programs. So we actually will pay the choir this year. Last time we passed the hat, and this time we actually have a grant to pay you. It never stops us from passing the hat, and should you need a hat, a hat will be provided. Next Friday is Christmas at the Palace, and Santa Claus, we hear, will arrive probably around 5:30 in the courtyard of the Palace, and then we'll have cider and cookies and musical performances. Okay, they got their own whole day. So we have other groups performing next Friday night from 5:30 until about 7:45 at the Palace. And if you'd like to bring canned goods, or there'll be a donation pot out as well. We do donate to one of the food banks here in town. And then next Sunday, we'll have Las Posadas, so meet us on the plaza and join our group from the from Holy Faith in Española as they do the annual performance of Las Posadas in the plaza. So come back often, and come back often this month to see St. John's and Contemplative Landscape before it closes. And thank you to the monks, thank you to the Schola Cantorum.